Hello guys, welcome back to El Merengue Culé. Unfortunately, Atletico Madrid just beat Real Sociedad 2-0. However, Ronald Koeman, after doing a lot of experimentations in the last 10 minutes of roughly the past 3 games, finally opted to start with a 5-in-the-back formation. To which I have 2 questions before the game starts. Will De Jong act as a single pivot, or will he be in a double pivot with Pjanic? And could this be the first time that we see Messi and Braithwaite up top? It could be a pretty interesting partnership. Guys, see you at the end of the first half. All right, guys, so that is the halftime whistle. Really quick, I'm gonna say I am loving the 5-in-the-back formation. It is a formation that I think is really getting the most out of Messi. He's looking active, he's looking happy. And the end of the half, we even saw him smile, joke around a little bit. It is a formation that really emphasizes the work from the outside backs, and straight off the mark, Tejino Dest is working very well with Messi. Messi's playing an interesting role in which he starts off centrally and then tends to look for the open space on the right-hand side, leaving Braithwaite by himself. Braithwaite is doing a pretty good game, a quiet game, still managed to get himself onto the scoreboard. In the midfield, I was actually very, very surprised to see that it's actually Pjanic playing as a single pivot and De Jong and Pedri kind of occupying that space above Pjanic. Initially, we saw a Pedri that was looking to shadow Messi's movements, so like always like a little bit step behind to associate well with Messi. And then as the half progressed, Pedri was occupying more of the left-hand side rather than the right-hand side. But the factor that I'm absolutely loving about this formation is how fast we're able to win the ball. And now the transition could be a little faster. At times it is fast. And we actually saw it in both of the goals. We're at halftime, 2-0 up. It's when we change the speed of the play, whether it be from a cross on the left-hand side or a cross from the right-hand side. And, well, it led to a beautiful Lenglet header from a Messi cross. A change of speed, a change of pace, putting a cross in its goal. Same on the other side, a beautiful pass from Messi to Sergino Dest, who crosses it, and Lord Martin Braithwaite puts it away. 2-0, guys, I am stoked. Really, really loving this formation right now. Another potential factor to throw in there is the fact that Griezmann's not really in the game, and you see Messi thriving. And again, going back to the fact that I don't believe Griezmann and Messi are compatible. Initially, Valladolid was looking to press us, not extremely high, but a relatively high line, and it was a bit of a headache for us. But after that first Lenglet goal, they didn't know how to cope with it. They haven't really reacted to the fact that they're down 2-0. It always seemed like the scoreboard hadn't really changed for them. If anything, after that first goal, they just sat further back, which invited us a little bit forward. And that is another factor that I really want to talk about, the 5-in-the-back formation. It kind of forces us to sit back and have a pressure cover balance between the outside back and any one of the 3 center backs, which, like we mentioned earlier, allows us to win the ball back and kind of look forward from the first pass. Guys, we are playing very, very well. I'm excited to see what the second half has in store for us. I will see you at the end of the game. Vamos! So guys, that is full time. 3-0 for Barcelona. What a day. And let me just tell you this. This is the first time that we end the game, and I am both happy with the result as well as our performance. It just feels so good. I felt like I'm out of words. Messi was looking fantastic. It reminded me a lot of the Messi that we're used to, the Messi from last season, from previous seasons, where he doesn't feel the necessity to necessarily create every single attack. He was okay with players with allowing players to get more touches, perhaps a 1-2, perhaps a cross to him. He was he let the game flow around him, which actually led to not only the team playing better, but probably himself having a better performances. We saw a lot of the quick passes to him off the first touch finish. Unfortunately, none of those went into the back of the net. But overall, great performance for Messi. Arguably, man of the match. I'm trying to think of anybody that could contest for it. I really liked Sergino Dest's performance on the right-hand side, but I think it is a man of the match, Messi. One thing that I did notice off of the get-go is that Barcelona was breaking lines with a lot of ease. Now, this brings up a few questions for me. Is it down to the five in the back formation, the fact that we're playing very well, or potentially the fact that Valladolid had a pretty bad game? I don't know. That's something that I want to continue to test this formation, test these tactics onto harder opponents that are higher up in the list that can create a lot of more dangerous attacks. I feel like this Valladolid had, they had so much trouble looking for an opening. I really can't recall a time where I was like, oh, actually, there was one of them too that I'll get to. But on top of that, besides this current game, another positive takeaway is that Villarreal actually managed to draw points going into or tying 1-1. This is great for us. I think I need to double check the table, but I don't think this actually jumps us ahead of them just yet. But keep in mind that both Villarreal and Sociedad are have a game in hand. Well, Sociedad has two games in hand. Now, the only negative that happened this game is that Jordi Alba actually picked up a yellow card, meaning that he will miss next game. And honestly, the way Jordi Alba has been playing the past four games has been insane. You know, the defending, attacking, he's providing a little bit of everything to the team. Stability with, it's going to be definitely a big miss for Jordi Alba. And now let's get on to the, I think it was the 65th minute. A beautiful association play between the Young and Pedri to an eventually back heel assist. Beautiful to Messi. Messi converts the goal and officially breaks the record for most goals with a single club, putting him at 644 goals with Barcelona. Vamos, Messi. We talked about it last game, how, you know, the fact that we dropped points against Valencia kind of took away from that. But today, it's pure celebrations. A record that nobody expected to be broken, and a record that won't be broken again. Congratulations to you, Messi. You deserve it. You had an amazing game and come out with a beautiful record in hand. Now, I do want to note that as the second half progressed, Valladolid, they weren't doing much to us. Barcelona wasn't looking for to make the 10, you know, wasn't looking to break the scoreboard. They did have a few other chances, but they started in bringing players. They brought in Firpo, they brought in Busquets, and they brought Umtiti. An Umtiti that I was very, very excited to see what he could bring, and honestly, I was disappointed. An Umtiti that, you know, you have a five in the back formation against a Valladolid that's not really attacking much. So I was like, if he has a good game, take it with a grain of salt. Valladolid is doing nothing. And what does Umtiti manage to do? He manages to impress me in a negative way. I mean, off the get-go, there was a sprint that he had to do. They played a ball in behind his back. And my goodness, he looked slow. It wasn't even like a nice little jog. It looked like he was walking when Valladolid had a counterattack. That was first strike. Second strike was he was in his own box and tries to do a fake kick into the goal type of thing. Loses the ball, pulls up by the lead attacker. And honestly, had he fallen, could have very much easily been called a penalty. Luckily for us, he did manage to get the tackle. Overall, not very promising. Ter Stegen also came up with another beautiful one-handed save. A stiff arm. Again, a beautiful save. And you know, if I believe at that point, if they were to score that shot, not the end of the world. But, of course, nice to see that we're taking home a clean sheet after such a great performance with five in the back. So that is what I'm asking for Koeman to do. Keep this formation. Keep this tactics. Carry on to the next game. See what it can do against tougher opponents. I liked it a lot. It gave us a lot of width, which in turn opened up the midfield a lot. It gave the Young, it gave Messi, it gave everybody that was playing down the middle more room to breathe, more room to create. We saw a Pedri that was very, very creative. I think, possibly one of his best games, for sure. So guys, once again, fantastic result for Barcelona. 3-0 victory. And now we do have two correct 3-0 predictions. The first one being to Patho and Chill, 3-0 prediction. Congratulations to you, as well as Ali Iswadi. Congratulations to both of you guys. Your name is now officially in the leaderboards to win this beautiful Barcelona jersey that I don't think anybody has predicted two correct scores as of now. So it is very tight, and I do recommend you to keep up with the predictions. You guys have been blowing up the comment section, and I love it. And guys, before I let you go, don't forget to check out the official Twitter page to interact with us and overall get updates. Guys, beautiful Barcelona victory. Hit a like if you enjoyed the video. As always, subscribe. Help us reach our goal of getting 3,000 subscribers by the end of the year. You guys are almost there, and I could not be more grateful and thankful for every single one of you. Guys, as always, Visca Barça!